Hi everyone, my name is David Kurth and I'm a technical advisor with our Azure Identity Authentication team. Today we're going to show you how to use the test SAML settings for enterprise applications. For this scenario, we navigated to the Azure Active Directory blade, then Enterprise Applications, and added a non-gallery application for the test RSA application. The details on how to set up identity provider or service provider initiated sign-on for this application can be found at sptest.imshowcase.com/instructions. If you need further instructions, this is the site you'll want to navigate to set up your environment. For this demo, I named my application RSA Sample App. For testing, we are requiring user assignment for this application, which can be found under the Properties section. To create the failure condition, we did not add the current user to the list of assigned users. By the way, the users can be assigned to the application by going to Users and Groups, then adding the user or groups there. After completing the setup from the single sign-on page, needing to at least complete step 1 in the single sign-on with SAML, you can scroll down to step number 5 and press the test button. Alternatively, you can use the Test This Application button at the top. On the Test Single Sign-On with RSA SAML App page, press Sign In as Current User. A new tab will be opened, and you'll be presented with the error, including troubleshooting steps. You can copy the error details by clicking Copy Info to Clipboard, return to the Azure Portal tab, and paste into the Resolving Errors box. Once the text is pasted, press the Get Resolution Guidance button. You will be presented with root causes and their proposed resolutions. For this particular scenario, we can see our first root cause is the user has not been granted access to the application in Azure AD. The resolution provided is, from Users and Groups, click on Add User to assign the user to the application. You can resolve the issue by manually copying the UPN of the test user to the clipboard, going to Users and Groups, then adding the user there. Alternatively, you can press the Fix It button and the portal will automatically complete this test for you. We can close the Test Single Sign-On with RSA SAML App window and test the SAML SSO again. This time, the sign-in was successful. For the second test, we return to the basic SAML configuration of the app and slightly modify the identifier of the application. Here, the identifier is also known as the Entity ID. We have also configured the SP-initiated sign-on settings for this demo. To reproduce the issue, we modify the identifier value in the basic SAML configuration. After saving the changes, we can perform one more test sign-in. This time, we are presented with a different error message. After getting the error and pasting into the Resolving Errors window, we can see that the following root cause of identifier mismatch, the identifier for the application is IAMShowcase, you have configured IAMShowcase-broken instead. The resolution proposed is, replace the identifier value configured for this application with the following value. The issuer value in the sign-in request, SAML request, sent by the application tells us what's the correct identifier to be configured. The Fix It button allows us to fix the identifier quickly. After applying the proposed fix, we will test the SAML SSO app again. This time, our temp was successful. As you can see, the built-in test single sign-on option can help you quickly identify and fix various application settings and misconfiguration. That's it for this time. Thanks for watching.